Hi guys, this is DivaLyn, and I am going to start doing a blog or a vlog on ways to get your family involved in going to Disney World or Disneyland. One of the things my family loves to do is have Disney parties. So I'm going to start doing vlogs on all the Disney parties that I've done in the last 5 years. So just keep tuned. Everybody subscribe and like this video and any videos to come. Disney vlog channel. I go to Disney yearly, and I'm going to show you ways to get your family involved in preparing for your trip. One of the things my family and I love to do is have Disney parties. So we pick a movie, we pick out food to go with the movie theme, and we decorate a little bit, and we have a good time, and we make sure we check off our countdown, and every Saturday or however often you'd like to do it, but it makes the time go fast as you prepare for these parties, and the family can cuddle up with some snacks and popcorn and watch a movie and get everybody all excited about your upcoming trip. So I'm going to start doing videos on all of my parties that I have done in the last 5 years. I'm going to start with the latest ones first because I've learned that I would rather spend my money in Disney World rather than on a party. So my parties that I've done this year are all under $30. And I'm going to show you how to do that and still make it fun and creative. So once you start to view my videos and you like them, be sure to click the like and subscribe so that I can keep bringing you videos. One of the first things you'll need to know is try to prepare your party meals around whatever you're already cooking, whatever's already in your cabinet. You don't have to go buy a lot of extra stuff. So, for instance, if you need to make a purple milkshake for a villain theme, if you have food coloring already in your house, you don't need to buy anything, just the normal things you would have, ice cream, milk, and you just add whatever colors you need. If you want pink, you just add a little red or whatever. Light blue, you add blue. So that is that. The other thing is a lot of decorations can be found not only at the dollar store, but at Walmart for 97 cents, or sometimes you find things on clearance, and you can use those things and have fun. Now, activities for these parties are also easy. They can be found if you find those little hanging things. They're like grab and go little coloring books. They have a lot of Disney and Universal characters, and they have everything you could possibly need at the dollar store. You can find things for cars, so they have little Lightning McQueen coloring books and water paints and all kind of stuff. So activities are simple. One of the other things you will need is a printer and some ink. That's about the most expensive thing. I have a Kodak printer that uses less ink, so I would print out maybe the menu or little labels to go under the foods. So that stuff will not be included in the under $30 thing. But our last party we did was Princess and the Frog, and I tried to do my party and not use the printer. So we had little memo cards left over from the end of the school year. So I wrote in cursive, nice and neat, all the foods, and I had some stickers around from Princess and the Frog, and I let the kids decorate the sign, and we used that. So again, you don't have to go all out and use a lot of money, but the kids had fun doing the stickers and making their own little creative designs. And that was it. We watched the movie, we had fun, we danced around. And at that time, the countdown was maybe 15 days. So yeah, so let's get it done. My first party is coming right up. And then after that, you'll see how every party I'll try to show you either in a description or right on the screen how much everything costs and where it came from. Another tip I have for you guys is use what you have in the refrigerator. If there's anything left over from the night before your party or 2 days before your party, use it up. Give it a Disney name related to whatever party you're doing, and just use it, and the kids will eat it because you've named it something else. I've had a whole party, I think it was superheroes, with mostly vegetables. My kids don't eat vegetables, but because it had a superpower today, they ate it. So use up leftovers, use stuff that you know, you wouldn't normally use or you don't think they would eat. Just try it. They may eat it because they're excited, they're in the moment, and if they don't, you are probably going to throw it out anyway. So that's one step I can give you as far as keeping your movie night under $30, and just have fun. It's all about making the memories. Your kids will remember these parties. We have so much fun. I think my favorite party was up, and we bought a bag of balloons from, I believe it was Walmart, but this was a long time ago. And days leading up to our party, we blew up all the balloons, and one of our activities were to put all the balloons at one end of the house by the back door. And we stand at the other end of the house. We have a long hallway. And we would run from one end to the other end, try to sit on and bust a balloon, and run back and touch the door, and come back and bust another balloon. Well, we each had 1 minute to see how many balloons we can each bust and who was going to be the winner. It was so much fun. We all did it. Even the baby did it. He was a baby at the time. He's going to be 6 now. But it was so much fun. So again, that activity took zero because we all blew it up. And I think the bag of balloons cost maybe $1. But my kids still remember that party. And I think my baby was 1 at the time. So just have fun. Make sure while you're doing this, it also keeps your kids engaged as far as you trying to save money. So if you say, we can't have this Nerf gun today or this Barbie doll today because we're here just to pick up stuff for the party because we're getting ready to go to Disney World, that usually encourages them to get excited about Disney World and not just have a meltdown in the store because they didn't get the Barbie or the Nerf gun. So just try to keep them engaged in the parties, get the kids ideas of what they would like to do. And if they're older, like my daughter now is 14, let her help you cook, let her help you prep the food or whatever. But I need you guys to stay tuned because I am the fun mom that will give you all kind of tips on having these wonderful parties. And I'm going to try to keep these under $30. And each party, I will name everything and how much it costs and where I got it from. And as I get back in parties like last year and beyond, those parties were a little bit more, but they were also a lot of fun. I just learned how to be more creative and save money doing it differently. So stay tuned. My first party I did this year was Mickey Mouse at our 100 day countdown. So that will be our first party that I'm gonna do. So everybody subscribe and stay tuned. Come back and let's have fun getting ready for our trip. Later. And now, I'm going to show you a glimpse of the Mickey ears that I'm wearing today that I made. These are the Dark Divas. They have all of the villains on them. And these are special ears because they light up. But they are also two-sided. So on this side, we have my favorite girl, Ursula. I love making Mickey ears. So subscribe and stay tuned for more parties and more Mickey ears.